أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى واستعين به واستغفره واستهديه. I'm asking Allah سبحانه وتعالى, dear respected brothers, dear sisters, أن يتقبل منا وإياكم صالح الأعمال يا رب العالمين. صلى الله سبحانه وتعالى يا رب العالمين to help us إن شاء الله to make طاعة after طاعة, عبادة after عبادة إن شاء الله رب العالمين. We just finish the الحجة and we're gonna start a new year 1444 from the Hijrah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, his migration, and inshallah the first يعني inshallah يعني of المحرم gonna start this Saturday inshallah رب العالمين. And we remember in the month of المحرم, which is the Hijri calendar started during the time of Umar ibn al-Khattab, when the Sahaba they sit together and they come to the point which is the whatever Sahaba said is correct and the sawab, because Sahaba they used to live with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Jibril alayhi salam he used to come to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sahaba they learned from Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. During the time of Umar they said, how can we start our Hijri calendar since the Fath Mecca or the Battle of Badr or whatever? They come to the opinion, they said, no, we're gonna consider it from the Hijrah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from Mecca to Medina. And Rasulullah was preparing for his hijrah, migration, from the beginning of al-Muharram. And the month of al-Muharram, one of the four sacred months, Dhul-Qa'da, Dhul-Hijjah, and al-Muharram, they come together, and Shahr Rajab, Mudar, before Sha'ban and Ramadan. We remember during these days why the importance of شهر المحرم. الله سبحانه وتعالى said إن عدة الشهور عند الله 12 شهرا في كتاب الله يوم خلق السماوات والأرض منها أربعة حرم قال فلا تظلموا فيهن أنفسكم. The month which is with الله سبحانه وتعالى, and he counted for us according to the sighting of the moon. How can recognize the month, new month, with the sighting of the moon? And it's a very strong proof for us. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, عند الله, this is the month of Allah. Like what he said, شهر of المحرم, شهر الله, the month of Allah. He said, ناقة الله, the camel, she camel of Allah. ناقة الله, رسول الله, بيت الله, the house of Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, شهر المحرم, شهر الله. This is the month of المحرم. This month, we are not celebrating the month of المحرم, or we are happy because of the killing of al-Hussein, or people beating their backs with the knives, and this is all innovations and fake. It has nothing to do with Islam. Islam said, don't be violent. Islam said, have mercy. Islam said, don't kill yourself. Islam said, don't harm yourself and harm others. And Islam against all of that. But we remember, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the month of al-Muharram, what should we do? Rasulullah said, the best fasting you can do after the month of Ramadan, the fasting of the month of al-Muharram. And the best salah, prayer, after Salat al-Farida, Qiyam al-Layl, Tahajjud at night. We learn too many things in this month. The day of 10th of al-Muharram, that day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Musa and his followers from Pharaoh and his followers. Allah saved them. The army of Fir'aun being destroyed, sinking, drowning in the Red Sea. And Allah saved Sayyidina Musa, Prophet Musa, and his people in that day. And when Rasulullah came to Medina, he found Jews, people, the Jewish, fasting that day. He said, why are you fasting the day of Ashura, 10th of Muharram? They said, because Allah saved Musa and his people, Bani Israel, from Pharaoh in that day. Rasulullah said, Musa is my brother. And he gave order to the Muslims. He said, نحن أولى به منكم. And he said, if anybody did not eat today, don't eat, continue. If somebody eats, stop eating, continue that day fasting. Because we are celebrating that day how Musa عليه السلام, Allah saved him and his people from Pharaoh. But he said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, لأن عشت إلى قابل, if I will live to next year, and he did not live, he died during this year. So after that, he said, I will fast 9th and 10th. The scholar, they said, you can fast 9th with 10th or 10th with 11th. It's up to you. المهم, make something different from the people, the Jewish. Don't do just the same day like them. And we're going to talk about that. But let's focus about the day of 10th of Al-Muharram when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed the Taghiyah, the transgressor, Fir'aun. And the story of Musa and Fir'aun is showing us the sira', the challenge between al-haq, the truth, and the falsehood. The challenge, animosity between the awliya al-Rahman, the allies of al-Rahman, the mu'mineen, and the awliya al-shaytan, the supporters of shaytan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from this story, he can destroy zalim, but by kun fayakun. ولكن الله سبحانه وتعالى قال ولكن ليبلوا بعضكم ببعض. الله سبحانه وتعالى examining us, ابتلاء is examining us. Why? قال ليتميز المؤمن من الايه دعي الايمان نفاق المنافق. How الله سبحانه وتعالى can separate the مؤمنين and the منافقين. How can we see this is منافق, this is a مؤمن. الله سبحانه وتعالى examining us with the fitna. You have to struggle, you have to strive. In the story of فرعون, Pharaoh and Musa in the Holy Quran, Allah mentioned it in 30 spots in the Holy Quran. 30 times Allah mentioned the story of Pharaoh and Sayyidina Musa. And the similarity of what happened to Musa alayhi salam with Bani Israel and Pharaoh, it's happened to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam and the people of Quraysh, Mecca. They were like acting like Pharaoh too. Tyrant people, transgressors, unjust people. وبني إسرائيل, إسرائيل هي يعقوب, Jacob. He came, he migrated from الشام, from فلسطين, كنعان, to Egypt during the time of Prophet Joseph. And they were 80 people. They were what? 80 people. And سبحان الله, from the time of Joseph عليه السلام, Prophet يوسف عليه السلام, to the time of second Ramses, اللي هو فرعون, the Pharaoh of the Quran, they became 600,000 people. From 80 people during, they migrated with Prophet Jacob, 12 tribes, 80 people. They moved to Egypt during the time of Sayyidina Yusuf and he honored them. They became Bani Israel, these 80 people, only 80 people, they became 600,000 people. And Sayyidina Yusuf honored them in Egypt. They take very high positions, good jobs, and they, because of Yusuf alayhi salam, and they honor them. During the time of Yusuf, Egypt, it was not the country of the Pharaoh people. It was the country of the king. Allah said in the Quran, وَقَالَ الْمَلِكُ, الْمَلِكُ, the king. And Joseph, he was the second man after the king. Yes, he was the financial prime minister. And they became 600,000 people. And when the Pharaohs returned back to their country, which is Egypt, they are the original, they fought against Hyksos. Who's Hyksos? The king of Egypt. Because, you know, I don't want to go more details about the history of Egypt, but they destroyed them. It was Hyksos. Sometimes they win, sometimes Pharaoh they won. And subhanAllah, after 600 years, what happened? The Pharaohs, they become strong again to fight to get their country because Egypt is a Pharaoh country. It is not Hyksos. Hyksos, they were slaves, Mamalik. And the king, he was one of them, Akhenaton, his name. It was fight. This country, subhanAllah, Egypt fighting all the time. Somebody won, somebody comes. Somebody comes, somebody won. Somebody, subhanAllah. This is the history from the beginning. Al-Muhim, this is not my problem. The problem is it started when second Ramses, Pharaoh, he saw in his dream that one child and one person from Bani Israel, he's gonna fight against him and he's gonna take his kingdom from him. Yes, the authority from him. And he started killing the children of Bani Israel, humiliating them, putting them in slavery. Wow, 600,000 people, putting them in slavery. And طبعاً if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanna do something, Allah will do it. كُن فَيَكُونَ وَاللَّهُ غَالِبٌ عَلَى أَمْرِهِ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. People don't know. If Allah want to do something, Allah will do it. What happened? You know the story of Musa alayhi salam. 1 year, he used to kill the boys. Second year, leave them, don't kill them. We need them to be slaves for us. If you kill all the boys, who going to serve Pharaoh? Nobody. But that's why 1 year, maybe somebody can say, why he tried to kill Musa, but he did not kill his brother Aaron 1 year before him. Because Aaron was older than Musa. Because that year, Aaron was born, he said, release the kids, don't kill them. Second year, we're going to kill them. Musa was born. And you know the story, what happened to Musa. And by the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when his mom gave the order to take him in the box in the Nile River, you know the rest of the story. Asia loved him and they adopted him and he grew up in the palace of Fir'aun with the money of Fir'aun, and Allah returned him back to his mom. Subhanallah. المهم, the story came. وأصبح فؤاد أم موسى فارغة إن كادت لتبدي به لولا أن ربطنا على قلبها لتكون من المؤمنين. القصة, you know that. He grew up in the palace of Fir'aun. They adopted him, subhanallah. And Allah said, ولما بلغ أشده, when he became strong, واستوى آتيناه حكما وعلما. Allah gave him wisdom and knowledge to سيدنا موسى. وكذلك نجزي المحسنين. He escaped when he killed the Coptic man. He escaped from Pharaoh to Jordan, and he was working as a shepherd for 10 years there, and he married the daughter of that pious man. And when he came back, طبعاً, you have to know that in the story of Egypt, if somebody killed someone, even during that law during the time of Pharaoh, if somebody killed someone and he escaped for 10 years, there is no judgment against him. خلاص, it will dismiss. The case will be dismissed. This is what happened to Sayyidina Musa. After 10 years, he came back to Egypt. خلاص, because his case has been dismissed. They cannot kill him. خلاص, 10 years out, خلاص, that's it. Dismissed the case. He came back with his wife, with his sheep, and he get the order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah talked to him, honored him after he passed the test. Subhanallah. You have to pass the test. You have to be examined. 10 years away from his mom, from his family, from Egypt, and shepherd, and long story. Work, struggling. He came back with the sheep, with the wife, with kids, and Allah talked to him in the way, not just that, Allah gave him the message. Subhanallah. Allah honored him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Musa, go to this kharban Fir'aun, because he is claiming his, the Lord so high, higher than me. Ana rabbukum al-a'la. He said, Magnoon. He said, I am your Lord so high. I'm higher than the God of Musa. Subhanallah. And when Musa alayhi salam went to him, said, man, you're not a God. You're stupid. You're not a God. Who are you? And subhanallah, he showed him the ayat, the signs, the stick, the hand, and too many ayat, 9 ayat, subhanallah, the frogs, the locusts, too many things, you know, the blood, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed him everything. He said, Musa, you're a magician, man. And taba'an, the magic during that time, it was the job of Fir'aun and his people. He used to train magician people, teaching each other magic. Why? To scare people. He used to give Yawm al-Zina that day, he used to call all Egyptians, come, stand in a big gathering, and get the magician, and show them sorcery, magic. And people, this is scare. This is the way how to scare people. Divide, scare them, they're going to listen to you. Weaken them, they're going to listen to you. And it was the policy of Fir'aun. Yeah, this is my, I have to, this is how I have to do this with people. And they said, Musa, you are just a magician, man. Musa was not a magician. You are the magician. You are the one who's been for magician. And he called all the magician, come. So I want you to defeat Musa today. Subhanallah, taba'an, you know the rest of the story. Allah sent him a tufan, the flood, the locusts, al-qummal, frogs, blood, and all they were the soldiers of Allah. وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُوَ. Subhanallah, it was them. فَأَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمُ الطُّوفَانَ وَالْجَرَادَ وَالْقُمَّلَ وَالضَّفَادِعَ وَالدَّمَ آيَاتٍ مُفَصَّلَاتٍ فَاسْتَكْبَرُوا وَكَانُوا قَوْمًا مُجْرِمِينَ. Musa, please, crying, ask your God to take the frogs away. Do you know what's mean the frogs? They used to eat the food, cooking food, and they used to take the food, like to eat, they see a lot of frogs jumping in their faces. They used to go to Nile River to drink water, sweet water. They put the cup of what they look at it like this, became blood. See what kind of life this? Locust was eating all the vegetations, everything, eating them, destroying them. Musa, please ask your God to take it away. We're gonna believe in you. Allah takes it away. Again, they deny, and Allah sends another sign, another punishment, one after another. Allah did not punish people just one time like this. After sending too many ayat, one after another, giving you another chance again. See how many times? Al-Tufan, okay, will be good, again. Al-Jarad, will be good, again, they lie. Al-Qummal, again. Al-Dafad, again. See how many signs? Subhanallah, too many chances. فرعون خربان. سبحان الله. This is called تمادي في الطغيان. Transgression. There is no end for it. This is what فرعون is. That's why Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And finally he said to Musa, listen. Take your followers and get out of Egypt at night. يلا. Get out. Go where? To بلاد الشام. Where is Jacob came from? Palestine. Go back. Go back to Palestine. Where is Jacob came from? They came 80 people to Egypt. They returned back to بلاد الشام. How many? 600,000 people, Bani Israel. Escape from Pharaoh at night. Go. Don't tell anybody that you're going. Subhanallah. When they reach the Red Sea, to go another side of Egypt, what happened to them? Subhanallah. Fir'aun was following them with his army and just to destroy them, to the Red Sea. فَلَمَّا تَرَاءَ الْجَمْعَانِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَلَمَّا تَرَاءَ الْجَمْعَانِ means they see each other's. Musa with his people, 600,000 people, they said, Ya Musa, إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ Man, you're putting us in problem all the time. These people, they used to live in slavery all of their life. They grow up in slavery. That's why قال لك أبو الطيب المتنبي بقى قال لك إيه لا تشتري العبد إلا والعصا معه إن العبيد مناجيس مناكيده أنجاس المناكيد أي أيوة والله يعني إيه بمعنى العبد the slave he came to certain point he said I want to be a slave يا عم I want to honor you I want to take you to be free to live your life to have honor he said no 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 I cannot because I grow up in this it is in my blood I want to be a slave فهم they said to سيدنا موسى يروت رب الميكر They insulted سيدنا موسى. He wanna save them. You're a troublemaker. سبحان الله. He said, إنا لمدركون. قال أصحاب موسى إنا لمدركون. البحر أمامهم. The front of them. The Red Sea. And فرعون with 70,000 soldiers behind them. And سيدنا موسى he said, no, no, no. Nay. كلا. Nay. What are you talking about? I'm a نبي. I'm a رسول. I'm talking to Allah. إن معي ربي سيهدي. رسول الله said it in the غار of حراء. Of ثور. غار ثور. When they were migrating to Medina. And that's where, remember, that's Muharram started with the Hijra of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Or the new Hijri calendar started with the Hijra of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not with the Battle of Badr or Fatih Mecca, no. They started with the Hijra. Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab with the Sahaba, they decided that. So Abu Bakr al-Siddiq when was telling Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, if any one of these kuffar, the cave is small like this area, small. They can see them. Ya Rasulullah, if any one of them gonna look under his foot, he's gonna see us. The Quran said that. Subhanallah. La tahzan inna Allah ma'ana. What are you talking about? Yes, subhanallah. Yani Rasulullah said to Abu Bakr, what do you think? Allah with us. Don't worry. Sayyidina Musa said, Kalla inna ma'ya rabbi sayahdeen. Don't worry. Allah with me. Even Fir'aun is coming and the ocean is here, but I'm certain Allah can help me. Kalla inna ma'ya rabbi sayahdeen. Tawakkul ala Allah. The same thing Sayyidina Ibrahim, when they put him in the manjaniq, flying, going to the hell, to the fire. Sayyidina Jibreel, Ya Ibrahim, alaka haga, maulana? Do you need anything? Alu la, mish azmin lak haga. Hasb Allah ni'mal wakil. Hasb Allah ni'mal wakil. Bas kida, khalas khalas al mawdu. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he saved Sayyidina Musa in the day of Ashura. Why you fasted that day? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Sayyidina Musa. And I read one tafsir also, they said, Allah saved also Sayyidina Nuh in that day. His ark was landing above Al-Judi. What is Al-Judi? It's a mountain between Iraq and Turkey. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Musa. قال واترك البحر رهوا إنهم مغرقون. خلاص. واترك البحر رهوا إنهم مغرقون. That's it. He was hitting the ocean with his staff and became 12 roads. Even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he make them happy, he used to open just rooms for them to see each other. Oh, you're still there? Oh, you're still there. Until they pass the ocean. And subhanallah, they get out and Sayyidina Musa again to the ocean and the ocean came back with water. And Fir'aun was with his arm all into the ocean. That's done. وَأَضَلَّ فِرْعَوْنُ قَوْمَهُ وَمَا هَدَى Fir'aun, he misguided his people. He did not guide them. This is the final abad of the enemies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِظَلَّامِ لِلْعَبِيدِ Muharram, really, this month is the month of barakah, rahmah, nasr, victory. The month of intisar al-muslimin. Too many listeners, but I'm going to make this in my khutbah tomorrow, not this one. Yeah, I'm talking about different subjects about al-Muharram tomorrow, inshallah. فَهِنَا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the month of al-Muharram, He's showing you that any zalim, any dictator, any whatever, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling him, we're going to destroy you the way you destroy Fir'aun. And look what Allah said in the Quran. فَكُلًّا أَخَذْنَا بِذَنْبِهِ. Each one of these zalimeen, Allah punished them because of their sin. Look, فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِ حَاصِبًا. قَوْمِ ثَمُودُ وَقَوْمِ إِهِ قَوْمِ ثَمُودُ وَقَوْمِ عَاد. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَخَذَتْهُ الصَّيْحَةُ. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ خَسَفْنَا بِهِ الْأَرْضِ like قارون. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَغْرَقْنَا like قارون and the people of Lot. خَسَفْنَا بِهِ الْأَرْضِ. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَغْرَقْنَا people of سيدنا نوح عليه السلام. وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيَظْلِمَهُمْ. Allah is not ظالم. Allah is so just سبحانه وتعالى. وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. They used to oppress themselves, their own selves. They were unjust to their own selves. In the month of Al-Muharram, you have to know that Al-Aqibatu lil-Muttaqeen. There is no way. The final abad, the final end, al-Nasr, the victory to the Muttaqeen. That's it. To the Mu'mineen. We have to know that. طيب, what should we do? تمسك بدينك. Your deen is a very important thing. ما اوعى تتنزل عن دينك لأي حد في الدنيا. اوعى. Don't give up your deen for anybody in this world. Because he will not benefit you. Your deen... like your flesh, your blood. Oh, don't. تمسك بالدين. الدين is a very important thing. Because me and you are going. We're going to leave. If you go without الدين, انت خربان. You have nothing. If you don't have anything in this dunya, but you have your deen, you have everything. والله العظيم. We are going. تمسك بدينك. هو الدين. Don't give up your deen for anybody. For anything. For any reason. الدين, 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 الدين. وما النصر إلا من عند الله إن الله عزيز حكيم قال إن سورة الغافر إن لننصر رسلنا والذين آمنوا في الحياة الدنيا ويوم يقوم الأشهاد. Those who will be victorious, our رسل, the رسل of Allah, and the مؤمنين, the followers of the أنبياء. In this dunya, في الحياة الدنيا, in this worldly life, ويوم يقوم الأشهاد, in the day of judgment, Allah will be with you, will be victorious. This is the main thing. يوم لا ينفع الظالمين معذرتهم. There is no any excuse for the ظالم in the day of judgment. ولهم اللعنة. They have لعنة. They will be cursed. ولهم سوء الدار جهنم. ففرعون, the one he said, ما علمت لكم من إله غيري. Oh Egyptian, listen. There is no God for you except me. هو هيز قرار. يعني قرار واحد بس. قرار واحد. واحد. Just one person is talking. Nobody else. I am the God. I am ربكم الأعلى. I am your Lord. So Lord, أليس لي ملك مصر وهذه الأنهار تجري من تحتي. Didn't you see the kingdom of Egypt? It belonged to me. The land belonged to me. And this river is under my knee. What happened to him? Allah destroyed him in the water because he said it's mine. Yeah, سبحان الله. فأجراه الله من فوقه والعياذ بالله. ونجى الله موسى. يعني فكان صيام before the month of Ramadan. The day of Ashura, the 10th of Muharram, it was fard for Muslims before the month of Ramadan. And if you fast that day, inshallah, Allah will forgive you the previous year, 1 year. Tabu, what about the day of Arafah? Remember, the previous and the coming. Tabu, what about the day of... see, ya akhi, Allah is gifting us day after day. We just finished the Hajj before Hajj Ramadan. And the day of Arafah, 2 years been forgiving. And this is, yalla, one extra bonus. Huh? Yalla, that... But don't tell me I have no sin. Yeah, you have a lot of sin. But these are the minor sins, not the major sins. Major sins need the tawbah. Remember, don't miss this. Huh? Not kabair. Yes, I'm talking about the minor ones. If you fast the day of Ara, the day of Ashura, inshallah, the 10th of Muharram, means inshallah, as-sana al-madiya, the previous year, will be forgiven, mashallah. Yeah, mashallah. And this is for the one who did not fast the day of Arafah. I will give another chance. Allah is giving us, ya jama'a, nafahat al-dahr, gift after gift after gift after gift. Why? Because if Allah one day he's going to punish someone, he has no any excuse. Walla yadlum rabbuka ahad. Didn't I give you Ramadan? Laylat al-Qadr? The first 10 days of the Hijjah? The day of Arafah itself, 2 years will be forgiven? Salawat, that's 5 times Salah. The day of Jum'ah, if you attend the Salat al-Jum'ah, the Surah Al-Kahf, you read it every Friday. Too many ways to be forgiven. That's why the one who will be punished, he's kharban. He's zero. There is no spot of khair in his heart like this. Wallahi. Even the hadith said, when Allah will intercede in the day of judgment, أخرجوا من النار من كان في قلبه مثقال حبة من خردل من إيمان. Allah will give order to the angels. In the end, if anyone has like a weight of an atom of iman in his heart, maybe once he said la ilaha illallah by mistake, get him out of hellfire. Allah will intercede. See, for the one who's going to send to the hellfire, that person, he's evil himself.